This is the Artic Liquid Freezer 3 Pro, and we have a thing or two about this $80-ish AIO. Will we come to our senses and finally give this internet darling its dues, or will we keep saying AI no to this AIO? We're gonna find out all about that right here, right now on Robeytech, after a word from our sponsor. If you've just built or upgraded your PC and now that Windows watermark just saying activate Windows is just sitting in your face, don't panic. VIP-CDKDeals.com is here to help. VIP-CDKDeals offers legitimate software activation keys at a fraction of the retail price. We're talking deep discounts on Windows 10 and 11, home and pro versions, plus Microsoft Office, Steam keys, and so much more. You can even use code RBCK at checkout for an additional 30% off. Check out VIP-CDKDeals.com today and get back to enjoying your PC without that watermark. All cards on the table. There was a lot of people who hated our review of the OG Liquid Freezer 3. It was probably one of the worst received videos from last year, and the comments section was very passionate about why. Did we beef a little bit harder with the Liquid Freezer 3 than we should have? Admittedly, we came out swinging a little bit harder with the negative sentiment than we needed to in that review, which was not our best look. To be clear, we're still not super big fans, see what I did there, of the Liquid Freezer 3, and stand by most of the criticisms we gave it on that video. Emphasis on most, not all of the criticism, which we're gonna address later on in this video. So we're gonna reopen that can of worms by reviewing the Artic Liquid Freezer 3 Pro and see what Artic has improved in their latest AIO. So let's get right into it. For those unfamiliar, Artic is a company that specializes largely in products related to PC cooling. So think air coolers, water coolers, and performance fans. Their design language for their products usually puts function before form, and generally, their coolers are cheaper than many alternative options from some of the more gamer-focused brands like, you know, your Asus ROGs, your Corsairs, and beyond. The last AIO cooler they released prior to this one is the Liquid Freezer 3 Non-Pro back in 2023. It was one of the better value options at the time, having solid noise performance. The cooler actually very quickly gained a sort of cult following. It also didn't hurt that it scored the uncommon and coveted positive review from Gamers Nexus. Now, when we got our hands on it for review and we tested it, as some of you know, we weren't super impressed by it. Now, the LF3 wasn't horrible by any means, but in our opinion, it had some design choices that we thought had the potential to cause more issues rather than alleviate them. In particular, we didn't have a great experience with the contact frame, especially when you consider the hypothetical beginner builder who would pick one of these up on such strong recommendations from other YouTubers. We also found that the process of installation was not quite as friendly as some of the other options on the market. Given it only had two screws to make contact with the frame rather than four, which made for a slightly more difficult experience. And then there was the offset mounting on both AMD and Intel CPUs. While Artic, I mean, obviously clearly knows a thing or two about cooling, having parts of the IHS exposed to dust and dander just felt like an unnecessary miss in the design. However, it was undeniable at the time that the LF3 provided great performance value per dollar, and it wasn't too expensive. Additionally, its thermal performance, while nothing to write home about, was solid and would give reliable cooling for some pretty beefy parts. This meant that if you could put aside the difficulties that may arise from the non-standard mounting procedure, then you would have a cooler that gives you a real bang for the buck, at least in 2023. Times have changed though, and in 2025, there is actually some very stiff competition in the budget realm of AIO coolers. We're talking options from Li & Li, Fantex, and especially Thermalright. And on top of that, the original Liquid Freezer 3 has hit its end of life, and it's become harder to get and more expensive by the day, which means that the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro is the official successor to the original Liquid Freezer 3. You could probably still find an original Liquid Freezer 3 on sale from a third-party seller on sites like Amazon or Newegg, but don't expect that to last a whole lot longer. Now, if you're a Liquid Freezer 3 superfan and you're sobbing over your keyboard because it's becoming end of life, then you're probably going to be pleasantly surprised to hear that the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro takes a lot from the original Liquid Freezer 3. Spoiler alert, the fans are kind of the only difference here, and according to Artic, they've been significantly upgraded. Now, the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro comes in both 240 and 360mm models, which also includes both RGB and non-RGB variations. Prices, they range from like $70 all the way up to $100, which means that they fall into the more budget side of options as far as AIOs go. For this review, we're focusing on the 360mm ARGB version, which is around $95 at the time of this recording. This puts the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro Pro close to the Galahad 2 Lite and the Glacier 1 M25 G2 in terms of price. But if price is the big reason you're considering this cooler, you need to keep an eye on Thermalright as they have options at the $50 to $60 range. As with anything though, remember that cheaper does not always mean better. Now, the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro supports LGA 1851 and LGA 1700 sockets, along with AM4 and AM5 sockets. Like its predecessor, it does keep the Intel contact frame, which takes some additional work to install, given you have to remove the standard pressure mount. This is a bit of a non-standard as far as out-of-the-box mounting options go compared with other AIOs, and is relatively unique to this AIO. What was also retained from the original is the offset mount of the cold plate. This is done so the center of the plate is closer to the hotspot of the CPU, which should theoretically give better cooling performance, but from what we're seeing, we're really not sure. Like we mentioned, we had concerns about this in the original Liquid Freezer 3, and we still think it's a bit silly, but if the cooler does its job, then I guess it's a preference thing at this point. The radiator is slightly thicker than the standard rads, coming in at 38 millimeters wide. Again, this was also the same as the original Liquid Freezer 3 and a key component for a performance-focused AIO. There are still some issues with the motherboard models where the pump can actually get blocked by the M.2 heat sinks. Artic has a list of conflicting motherboards on their site and will send a compatible heat sink if you reach out to them. This is another consideration to add on the growing list of concerns. Like we said earlier, its fans are the biggest upgrade, which sets the Pro apart from the original model. Artic advertises the fans run from 600 all the way up to 3000 RPM with 6.9 millimeter H2O of static pressure and 77 CFM of airflow, which for context is pretty massive when you look at the spec for spec of other AIOs. Compared to the original fans, the Pro's fans take a significant leap in specs, which in theory should mean that they vastly outperform the original ones. But more on that in just a bit. So just going off the specs, we're getting the impression that a lot of the concerns we had with the original are still going to be present on the Pro. However, we might be able to overlook some of those complications if the thermals are just that much better than the previous model. Now, Artic advertises some pretty significant thermal performance gains with the new fans, but as always, we did our own testing to find out actually how this holds up. So with that, let's talk about the thermal data. As we get into our testing, all of our AIO tests are performed in nearly identical Intel and AMD systems. These are PCs, not benches. So notes on the screen for details. All of this is done with the same conditions to keep the data as clean as absolutely possible. Now we're gonna go through this pretty quickly, but if you wanna see more, well, that's what the pause button's for. Before we get into the data, how are you enjoying the video? Consider dropping a like if you like, or even a dislike if you don't, or even hitting that sub button down below if you wanna see more of our content. We know that everyone says this, but it seriously does help us out a ton, and the feedback helps us figure out if we hit the mark or if there are things we can improve. Now, let's jump into the data, starting with our Intel bench. At CPU idle, the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro held thermal averages just above 29 degrees Celsius. This temperature average put it in between the budget-conscious Vtrue Lurker V360 and the budget-buster Trix Panorama SE ARGB. Remember, this is a baseline just to show where these AIOs are starting from. So let's talk about CPU load. The Liquid Freezer 3 Pro averaged in the middle of our tested AIOs, falling in between an 82 and 83 degree average, though it leaned a bit towards the warmer side. For some comparisons here, that was over 3.5 degrees Celsius cooler than the non-Pro's average, and again, paired off with the Lurker, which loved lurking in the Liquid Freezer 3 shadow, and the $55 Thermalright Aqua Elite. Looking at the average wattage here, the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro keeps its CPU power draw at an average of a bit over 235 watts, which translates into a Cinebench score of 33,548. Interestingly, the LF3's power draw is on the lower side of our charts comparatively, but that's still translating into a higher performance number overall. Now moving on to our gaming benchmarks, the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro averaged just shy of 56 degrees Celsius, which landed it between the CPS PC Cooler DT360 and the Gambius Xeon E4. Now from a power draw standpoint, the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro averaged closer to 104 watts, positioning it next to AIOs like the HydroShift 2 TL and the Lurker again. Now moving on to the AMD side, at idle, the Liquid Freezer 3 hovered in the 39 to 40 degrees Celsius range, placing it right next to the HydroShift 2R and the non-Pro Liquid Freezer 3. Under CPU load, the LF3 Pro falls in the middle of the pack with an average temperature just over 87 degrees Celsius. This positioned it in between the Darkflash DH360D and the HydroShift 2R. As for power draw under load, all of our AMD test AIOs are averaging around 144 watts with the LF3 falling right in the middle again. The story is similar when we look at the Cinebench score with the Liquid Freezer 3 hanging out in the lower portion of the middle with a score of 19,555. In our 1440p gaming benchmarks, the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro held average temperatures just under 58 degrees Celsius, which made it our second warmest running AIO on AMD and gaming next to the non-Pro Liquid Freezer 3. As for power draw, the LF3 Pro averaged just under 80 watts, positioning it next to AIOs like the Frozen Warframe SE and the Xeon E4. Now, thermal performance is one thing, but what about noise levels? We recorded the Artic Liquid Freezer 3 Pro at a little over 54 decibels in our gaming benchmarks and just over 69 decibels with fans running at 100% under full CPU load. We look across the landscape of our tested AIOs, the Liquid Freezer 3 was the loudest during CPU load and gaming tests, which does make sense with the amount of air they're moving with those brand new fans. Now, one more data point to look at with our relative value proposition and some fancy math. As a reminder, we're looking at the retail price divided by the difference between the CPU thermal max, which is 100 degrees Celsius, and the average CPU temperature under load. This gives us a dollars per degree of cooling value, which we can then score and compare. In this case, the lower the number, the better. These numbers are based off of data we collect from our Intel benchmarks and the MSRP at launch. Understand that values will change over time, but you can do the math to see where they land today. With a relative value score of 8.6 though, the Artic Liquid Freezer 3 Pro falls in our rankings in between the non-Pro Liquid Freezer 3 and the Be Quiet Silent Loop 3. Okay, so with all that said and done, where do we stand on the Artic Liquid Freezer 3 Pro? Did we have a dramatic change of heart? When we look at the data, it just left us asking, what does this AIO do at this price point that isn't done better and more conveniently by comparably priced AIOs? I know, we didn't even bring up the VRM cooling just yet, but we're gonna get to that in just a minute. Listen, opinions and personal preferences aside, the data isn't giving us anything to get excited about. We're not seeing it top thermal or performance charts, but we're also not seeing it fail either. It's just okay. So that leaves us in a place where we see some pros, some cons, and some neutral considerations that don't really fit in either camp when it comes to this cooler. Let's start with the cons. Remember, these are our opinions and observations. Since the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro is basically the same as the original Liquid Freezer 3, a lot of the same gripes we had with the original are still present with the Pro model. Maybe that'll change with the Liquid Freezer 4, but for now, our original critique stands with difficulty of installation versus what was actually gained by that difficulty. In fact, during our test runs of the Liquid Freezer 3, when we were installing the contact frame, it ended up being slightly askew, and therefore the PC wouldn't post. Of course, we took it apart, reseated it, and obviously everything was absolutely fine. But when you think about this from a new builder, they're not gonna know that. And in the end, they may think they have a faulty CPU. Is that pain potentially worth what you would get thermally? All that being said, I do wanna revise some of our original criticism from our review of the Liquid Freezer 3 and just re-clarify our position. There are so many small considerations regarding the installation that it can lead to some annoyances compared to other similarly priced coolers on the market. Things like making sure your NVMe heat sinks won't block the pump, having to unscrew the LGA socket hardware and Intel boards, having only two screws to apply even pressure to the cold plate, even the thicker radiator, as much as it's a bonus for long-term cooling, all of these things have potential to cause issues somewhere down the line of your build. Now, to be fair here, everyone's experience with the installations are going to be different. Some commenters on our Liquid Freezer 3 review shared their own horror stories, while others wondered if the same people had even ever turned a screwdriver. That being said, I can admit that we went a little off the rails in our original video with how much of an impact the negative aspects of this AIO actually took over our presentation, and our snark got in the way of our data. Now, we understand the design choices like the ones Artic made don't always guarantee that a problem is going to happen. And again, we've heard plenty of first-time PC builders who've used the Liquid Freezer 3 and have had zero problems with it. As long as you are careful and you take your time to read the instructions, or in this case, watch the instructional videos from Artic, then you're gonna be able to install it just fine. And while the design choices might not be super impactful to builders who take ample time to do it right, that still doesn't mean this isn't an overall con for the product. We still think that there are much friendlier pump mounting designs out there at the same price point that just perform better. Could this be changed in future iterations? Well, we really hope so. As for some neutral considerations, honestly, we still think the offset mount is just kind of weird. As far as we're aware, the IHS is designed to evenly spread the heat across the entire surface of the CPU. It's in the name. Wouldn't that mean having the cold plate contact more of the IHS would be better overall, rather than having some of it not make contact just to cover more of the hot spot? Or why don't you just do what others did and make the cold plate bigger? I mean, Thermalright did it for less. That seems to make a lot more sense to us, but we could be totally wrong on that. We're not thermal engineers or completely understand the cost of cogs. Now, if you are and you know more about that than we do, let us know. And I do mean that sincerely, but the data doesn't even show those benefits either. Again, this is kind of a neutral consideration though, because at the end of the day, if the AIO cools your CPU well enough with the offset mount, then does it really matter how it's mounted? Not really. Moving on to the pros, there are some definitive wins for the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro. The fans are definitely an improvement to the original ones. We're happy to see that it wasn't just a mild redesign just for looks, that these are actual technical improvements that feel worthy of the Pro title. Sure, they were a bit louder than other fans we tested, but we imagine some people wouldn't mind the trade-off for the increased amount of air that they actually push. The other pro here is that if you are an overclocker, having a pump head VRM fan might just provide you with the edge you were looking for. If I'm being completely honest, I don't think it'll be more than just a neutral add for most users, but still, I have to say we are happy that there is a moderately priced option on the market for people who will find a genuine use out of having some extra VRM cooling. At the end of the day, if you love this AIO, that's great. Don't let us dissuade your opinions of it. Overall, the Liquid Freezer 3 is performant and it shows its capacity to cool. However, if you're on the fence about whether or not this should be your next AIO, we'd encourage you to look at the data, look at what you need the cooler to do, and then decide whether or not everything we share in this video is a pro or a con for you. And with that, we're gonna wrap up our thoughts on the Artic Liquid Freezer 3 Pro 360mm AIO. But we wanna know what you think. If you love the Liquid Freezer 3 family, tell us why. We'd actually love to hear what it is that you love and what these coolers have made possible for you. And if you've bought a Liquid Freezer 3 Pro and you've struggled with it, be respectful, but what were the challenges you experienced and what did you wish you knew at the front end? Let us know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, why don't you go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and you know what? We appreciate you joining us. If you have any other questions or you want to continue the conversation, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Amazing place to talk to other people about your concerns, and you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, follow us on all the other socials, at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for making it this far in the video. We look forward to seeing you on the next one.